Ah, someone's here. Oh, it's Cameron. Hello.
I'm like genuine. Oh my god, I literally want to start crying right now. Haven't even like said a single word yet. I'm literally about to start crying right now. Alright, we got some people in here. Guys, I'm really sorry that you're coming in to... I'm on the verge of breaking down in tears right now. Sorry. Hey. So, I'm glad you're able to make it for this one. We got 9. I'm just checking my DMs, you guys, sorry. Am I ready for this ending? No, I am not. Alright, guys. Hey. Hello. I am, alright. So tonight's the night where I finish Fallen Order. I am in, so the reason why I'm late is because I'm really trying to finish my Daredevil rewatch. And I just watched season 3, episode 12, which is genuinely, like, it is so hard for me. I was literally... like 15 minutes ago, I was like having an entire breakdown. I was like shaking and crying and yelling. That's why I'm late. So I'm really in a great headspace to start the ending of this game. After crying over Matt, it's time to cry over Cal. I actually was not crying over Matt. I was not crying over Matt at all. Maybe a little bit at the end. I was crying over someone else. If you've seen Daredevil, it's like, I don't even want to say, because it could spoil it for anyone who hasn't seen it, if I even, I don't want to, I was actually not crying over Matt. There are other people besides Matt who deserve my tears. No, don't worry, I'm not gonna say. And I'm crying for a lot of different reasons, by the way, so, don't. It's a very complex situation in the show, so don't go, like, assuming, like, oh, she said she's crying, so this thing must happen. It's not, it is so far from being that simple, but anyway. Like, right, like, if you've seen the show, then, like, you know what I'm, like, you know what I'm talking about. It's very complicated. There are lots of reasons to be crying. Anyway, I really went from watching 3x12 to coming on and playing Fallen Order. Do you need to plan my funeral 3.0? It's possible. No, guys, I'm, like, dead serious. This is not about to be... I'm really sorry if it gets awkward with how emotional I get today, because I'm going through it. That episode destroyed me. No spoilers, though. I mean, saying that, like, literally every single episode, like, you could say that about literally every episode of Daredevil. So saying that it destroyed you, I don't think is a spoiler, because that goes for, like, over half of the series. Oh, I'm sorry that you're sad, Star Wars Premium. I hope that, maybe me being sad for silly reasons will help you feel better, I hope. Look at all these fun stickers and things in the chat. This is really fun. Alright, well... Oh, I don't want to hit the X button. Is it time to get started? Oh, yours is silly too? Okay. I got a little scared for you for a second there. I was like, oh my god, is something actually. Is something wrong? Okay. Oh my god, I have a knot in my stomach. I literally feel sick right now. Maybe it's because I haven't eaten enough today, actually. But I just ate, so I should be fine. I'm just in such a place to be doing this right now. Oh my god. I don't want to do this. Oh, the No Way Home premiere is right now and you're not there. Understandable. Yeah, I'm not seeing No Way Home until Saturday, so it's actually gonna be. This is kind of my last hurrah before getting off the internet for the rest of the week. Oh my god, here I am. Oh, I'm not ready to finish this game. This game has come to. It's. I mean, I've only had it for like a week, but it's just come to, like, be such a comfort. Because even though it's so sad, it's like there's kind of. I mean, there's kind of comfort in the sadness, to be honest. Just because sometimes there's nothing like getting torn apart by fiction. I mean, depending on how it does it. Like Daredevil, that's not a comforting kind of sadness. But this one kind of is. And I think especially because of how much it's about the game is really very much about like rebuilding more than it is about the suffering itself, I think. And there's just something like so. There's just something so like comforting and like healing about that. I don't really want to let it go. Okay, so basically I've got 3 skill points and I don't know what to do with them. So I figure, you know, we'll use them up before I enter the end game. Any suggestions? Got 3 skill points. Abuse, burst, slow. That's a good, burst, slow. Maybe I can. That could be useful. I can see that being useful. I can see that being useful if there are, like, a lot of people attacking me, you know? Might as well extend the power throw. I can only do one of those things, because those are both two. But I'm not sure how much I'm going to use the power throw is the thing. It might be the kind of thing that I just like spam, to be honest. Like that's either going to be a thing that I never use or that I spam. I can only do one of these things. You know, I kind of like spamming fancy attacks that aren't too complicated, like that don't really involve timing where I can just spam it. Like that's how I beat Malakos. Hello, first time chatter. Oh, I'm getting multiple pieces of advice here, and I'm not sure which one to follow. Patience and abusing push are best against the final boss. Yeah, I spammed the. I, like, abused the split lightsaber ability in the Malakos fight. Like, that's how I did it. That's how I did the fight. Now, granted, it was not actually very hard for me, the Malakos fight, because I'm on story mode and they made it so easy. They made it so easy. But that's how I finished it. I spammed the split lightsaber move. Okay. So lightsaber throw is good at the start of the end, but you use burst slow for the final boss. Okay, well I have a version of the lightsaber throw, so I'll at least be able to like do it, even if it's not at like the full
difficulty. I mean, the full, like, power. Which will probably be fine because I'm on story mode anyway. And then maybe burst slow will help. Just because slowing something down might be useful. Yeah, why not? Do it. You killed the final boss on Grandmaster difficulty in one go. Good for you. Congratulations. I'll never be able to do that in my entire life. But I'm fine with that. That's not what I'm here for. I mean, I have, like, one random- maybe I'll be lucky enough to get, like, a second skill point. I don't know. We'll leave it for now. Alright. I can, like, hear myself talk, and I really- sorry if I sound, like, boring and mean right now. I feel like I usually sound a lot more animated than this, but I'm kinda, like, suffering. Like, I don't really wanna end the game. I'm also sad about Daredevil. God. It's a bit... BD1... I'm gonna talk to BD1 and see if it makes me feel better.
Feeling okay?
No, I'm not. Thank you for asking. Why did that make me wanna cry?
Hi, BD.
Oh, that was cute. That makes me feel better. Can I talk to my friends?
Quiet. Too quiet.
Can I? Okay. Because I did already do the dialogue last time, but I just want to see, like, maybe there's something else.
Excuse me, Kel. I am not used to such talkative company.
Sorry, Marin. Like, I did all the dialogue last time at the end of the last stream.
But... BD1, keep an eye on Kel for us.
Aw. I'm sure he will. Okay. Oh my god, I literally have, like, butterflies in my stomach right now. I just want to curl up in a ball and not do anything. I'm so nervous. I feel sick. Okay. Just got on, have you missed anything? Nope, just me talking about how I'm sad. And also, welcome to the final stream, good to have you. Okay. We're going over there. Okay. How do I get there? I can't think straight. How am I supposed to plan a path? I can't plan a path because I can't even think right now. I feel ill. Okay. So, okay, I'm gonna go over here probably. What's gonna get me there? Okay, if I get onto here. And then it looks like I might be able to take, like, a zip line to over here and over here. So maybe just get to that center, that, like, center island right there. There. She's screwed. I know I am. People have told me that I'm screwed. I would have assumed that I'm screwed anyway. I screwed myself by watching one of the saddest episodes of Daredevil immediately before this. I cried my eyes out. Literally, like, shaking and crying, like, 20 minutes before getting on here. I'm making so many mistakes tonight. I might have to mute myself because I'm gonna be, like, crying too hard. I'm gonna be embarrassed. Getting on the place I want to get on. Hello, Cloud. Okay, which one do I want to take? I guess this will get me where I want to go. Oh, I feel ill! I feel positively ill. What is happening? Why? Okay, well, at least I didn't fall off. Okay.
Sensing something weird.
Me too, Cal.
This is gonna sound strange, but I think it's the Astrium.
What? what?
The closer we get to the vault, the stronger it feels. Careful, buddy. We still don't know how this thing works.
Oh my god, I literally feel sick to my stomach. Okay. Save over here. It's the calm before the rising storm. Don't even talk. Oh, we've got a turnout tonight. Have I ever had this many people watching? You guys really. This is like. This is 3 times the amount of people I usually have. So something really must be about to go down if this many people want to show up for it. Good God.
Here we go, BD.
Here we go, BD. I'm literally gonna start crying. It's probably just anxiety. I don't have anxiety. Okay. Here we go. I just get really nervous about stories because I get very attached to them. Oh boy, what's going on?
Amazing. The vault itself is built like a giant holocron.
Something
about that wall. We're close. Check it out.
Okay. Well, it's like a reflection. Ray vibes. Ray vibes. Okay. Oh, what's this?
I offer this record of our civilization to those who will follow.
Oh, this is interesting. Turn my volume up.
Despite our wisdom and technological achievement, we face extinction. Darkness, blindness.
Here we go, guys!
And gradually we allowed our pride to corrupt us.
Please don't! No, I'm like, serious, you can't be... I'm really not liking the, like, here it comes in the chat. I don't know what that means. I'm really scared. Oh my god, what's gonna happen?
We saw, the further we found it to ruin.
Hey.
I lead the remnants of my people into the great unknown, hoping that we will finally find peace.
Huh. That kind of sounded like a prompt. Where do I go now? I'm so scared. The knot, like, in my chest right now. Just the knot that is my, like, entire, like, torso area of my body right now. Okay, let's do a thing.
I shall teach them the ways of the Force.
Master Kestis.
We shall begin with physical preparation.
What is the Force?
Oh, what's this?
Another round, everyone.
Master Kestis, do you think the Empire will find us?
Okay. Hey, kids. I feel like this is... not quite how we expected things to go. Okay. I feel like I need to be commentating more, but I'm literally so nervous I can't even speak. What's about to happen?
It's the Empire!
Ah!
The Inquisitors have found us. Master, shall we fight them?
They're coming!
To the trenches!
Of course, I saw
Keep
that
going.
Coming.
Protect yourself!
capture the younglings. Kill the rest. They're back. They're firing.
Do I need to, like, kill them? Death scream? What can I... What do I do? Can I do anything?
Keep searching. They can't have gotten far.
Why are they making me do this? This is...
Target sighted.
Help me, Master Kestis!
Moving in.
I wish I could.
Spread out. There will be others.
Yes, sir.
You can't hide.
This is so nightmarish. My kid! I feel positively sick. Oh my god, what's gonna happen? What's gonna happen when I hit the button? No, I know it's only a vision, but it's a really distressing vision. I don't like the vision. Hi! Hey there! Hi, Trilla!
Surrender now, and we may spare the youngest. That's right.
Oh my god! Hey! That scared me!
I'm frightened.
I'm sorry!
What's gonna happen?
Not something good.
Master Kestis, why?
No, don't say that to me!
I want to go home.
Stop it, me too. Stop saying things like that to me. Not the crying softly. I don't like this very much. Oh my god, they're torturing my kid! I really have to distract myself. I'm really sorry. So I'm gonna do it by changing my outfit. I'm in a lot of distress. There was one. They're here. This is the one. Okay, this is gonna be what we wear for the end game. Sorry, guys. I need to stop for a second. Okay. Is that... Can I stop that from happening?
I had a bad feeling I'd see you here.
Oh?
How uncharacteristically prescient of you. Here I thought your greatest virtue was your dogged persistence as you stumble from one debacle to the next.
Guess you made a mistake not killing me on Brock, and then...
I scant mercy.
I wagered one meaningless Padawan against a prize that will win me the Emperor's favor.
You think I'm gonna let you walk away with the holocron?
Don't worry, it doesn't happen.
We both
no, but people
pride,
have lied to me
but
before.
But yours has cost you the lives of all the Force-sensitive children on that list.
You guys don't even...
Well,
I don't know if you think I'm kidding. I literally
like you said,
feel
Trilla,
sick right now.
I'm persistent.
Hi, Trilla. Oh my god, I forgot how to fight.
Not
I literally forgot how to fight. Hold on. I need to regroup. Stop it! I'm in so much distress. I don't remember how to play the game. I don't remember how to play the game. Go away. Oh my god, she can throw? Oh my god, where'd she go? There you are. Heck, I'm gonna die.
That thing. It's been through hell.
Oh my god, he's psychometrying the thing!
Don't go.
No!
Stick together.
No.
I'm going to lure them away, and then I'm going to circle back. Stay with the young ladies, Trilla.
Why am I watching it from a first-person POV?
Master, don't leave us!
What's going to happen?
It's okay. It's okay.
Oh my god, why am I getting tortured in first person? I can't even look! Why?! Stop it! Oh my god, I hate torture so much, please stop it.
Patch me up.
Can you patch me up? All right then. Is this at dark brightness? It looks darker for you guys than it does for me. The brightness is admittedly pretty dark, but it looks good for me, so I play it that way. Sorry if there's anything that you guys can't see, but... Where do I go now? Return to the Mantis! Okay, then! I'll go back to the Mantis. Yeah, this is how I get out. I feel positively sick. Please. Oh, you've got to be kidding me.
I think I'm done.
All right, who has the big gun? Dude, oh, you're dead. Hey. Am I now? Everywhere.
What are you doing here?
On what are you doing here?
Powerful.
Can I jump up there?
Look back.
No, I can't. Okay.
Get the Jedi.
Get up there. Can I just...
I've got a shot! One for your aim!
Oh, right, I can pull them off.
Don't be next. You don't scare me.
Maybe I should. You know, I kind of scare myself a little bit, to be honest. After that. Fractured plane. Same. The music is like infuriatingly charming right now. They are really not reading the room with the score.
Here. I saw what happened between you and Trilla, what you both went through.
Oh my god.
I'm so sorry.
Ah!
I was arrogant, I was foolish. I could never understand what you went through.
Oh my god.
She has a holocron. I don't know where she's taking it.
I'm responsible for the path that Trilla is on.
No, this sucks because I'm.
All of my mistakes.
I was just spiraling so hard over guilt-driven characters and Daredevil. That's the whole reason why I was crying.
And it's all of our responsibility, and it's about what we do next that's important.
And now this.
You taught me that, Seer.
Oh!
You're right. I know where she's taking it.
Mm-hmm. Where?
There's a fortress.
A fortress?
Where they take Jedi.
Great.
Where the Inquisitors come from.
Great.
It's a place of torture.
Awesome.
It's the place I escaped.
Great.
I just never thought I'd be going back there.
Oh, sorry, Seer.
Won't be going alone.
Won't be going alone.
I'll have a friend with you.
Of course.
Now... I'll have a Jedi with me.
Ah! my god, Neil. Is she gonna... And she... Oh my god. Oh my god. Is it... No! You know, it's not... It's a little mismatched.
By the right of the council.
We're kind of just using what we got,
but... By the will of the force. Kestis. Rise, Jedi Knight.
Good job.
You are ready.
So are you.
Yeah, Cal really just got knighted by red lighting. I mean, the thing is, destination unlocked, Fortress Inquisitorius. Shut up. Shut up. I don't want to go there. I don't want to go there. It's either being knighted by a red lightsaber is either a really bad omen, or maybe, if we want to be a little hopeful, it's just a symbol of how, you know, the Jedi just have to make do at this point. Nothing is what it was. The Jedi Order doesn't really exist anymore. That's the lightsaber they had on hand. That's the lightsaber we knight with. It's just, it could be just a symbol of how Force users are just finding ways to make it work. If we want to be a little hopeful. And it's also like, I feel like there's some meaning there. Because it's an object of like so much pain. Being used for something that represents moving forward, you know? Because Cal becoming a Jedi is, like, such a huge, like, step for him in his healing and in his growth. That's something that's moving forward. That's something new. That's something that's rising out of the ashes. But it's being done, there's like an irony with it being done with an object that that holds so much pain. Which I don't really know. I have the two dots, I'm not sure how I'm connecting them. I'm sure there's something deeper there, if only I could think straight. Alas, that's not quite working out at the moment. Seer couldn't knight Trilla, but she knights Cal with Trilla's saber. Yeah, wow. Seer had tapped into the dark side, so the fact that she used the red lightsaber to almost amend her darkness by doing something good feels befitting. Yeah. Yeah. Cal already was a Jedi? How? He was a Padawan when Order 66 happened. It's an inverse parallel to the holocron being used as a weapon. That's good. It's a good thought. Lots of good thoughts in the chat right now. I'm sorry, I need a second. I literally feel ill. I literally feel sick. Okay. Wait, I left my water on the other side of the room. Hold on a second. Gonna get it. Ugh. Sorry, I'm just gonna chill. If I can just chill for another second. What planet am I at? You just got here. Hello, thank you for joining. I'm on Bogano. I just finished the Bogano Vault, and I'm about to go to the Fortress Inquisitorius, so I just got knighted.
So I'm just kind of taking a second to try and breathe because I'm in quite a lot of distress. I'm very nervous about for what's whatever's about to happen. Don't feel great about everything that just happened. Well, getting knighted was kind of nice, but yeah. I'm just taking a second. I'm really in so much distress right now. Like, I've been on here for 40 minutes. I think I've been crying for all of them. For every single minute. Just give me a second, guys. Alright, I guess... Oh, I don't want to do this! I don't want the game to be over! I really don't want it to be over. I really don't want it to be over. Where am I supposed to go? Is that where I'm supposed to go? Up here? I'm assuming. Over here? It doesn't have the little Jedi objective thingy on it, but I've been to all the other... Well, I'm just assuming.
You Jedi love going from one problem to the next.
Or is it farther down? Are we still going down? We're going down, down, in an earlier round. We need some space emo music right about now. This looks like a door. That is a door. Good to know. Hello, door. Nope, that's a thing. Can I go around that? Can I? Nope, that's a dead end. Why is this happening? Bruh. I can't. Okay. Wait, can I go up?
Airlock 8 is clear.
Oh, that makes sense.
Hostile, get ready!
Range
fight now.
You have to deal with me now, Jedi.
You have to deal with me.
Cal, you there?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good to hear your voice, Seer.
I've located the holocron. Sending you the location now.
Got it. We're on the move.
Okay. So we're just going. We're just. Why does this feel like a hallway fight? Like, what I feel right now feels like when you know a hallway fight is coming in Daredevil. Anyway. Give me the slice. Okay, here it is.
Door? Meet BD.
Why are we making jokes at a time like this, Mr. Kestis?
You will regret that.
Oh, right, I forgot I can do that. Awesome. Someone else, yep, I just killed him. Okay, here we go. Oh god, I hate you so much. Okay, not doing too bad. Oh god, he scared me.
Don't let up. He's deadly.
Get in here.
Catch him.
Oh, there's someone behind here.
All right, again. No more gunners. Figures. Smash him.
This place is where the Empire created the Inquisitors.
Yeah, sure.
Tortured Seer and turned Trilla to the dark side.
Oh, cow.
Let's tear it down, BD-1.
Oh my god. There's so much fighting!
Can you hit him? I'm stepping back. Yeah, I got him.
Get off. Let me go!
Someone get him.
Guess while you're over here. Good god.
Seer, I've cleared out this area, but the Empire sealed me in. Any ideas?
Cal, look for a control room. I've got a plan.
I think I'm standing in one.
Okay, so obviously, are you kidding? Do I have to puzzle right now? Do I do this first, or do I do this first? Which one do I do first? I have a knot in my stomach. I don't know if that's normal. Well, I've had a knot in my stomach since I logged on 50 minutes ago, so... If it's not normal, then we can just be not normal together. Did you really say impressive view at a time like this, Cal? I know that you feel a lot of wonder at the galaxy, but oh my god, Red... What's this? Answer me this. What's up? Terrible. Absolutely sickening. Okay, well... Absolutely. When I say absolutely sickening, I mean it with all my stomach. With all my stomach. I feel so ill. Okay. Do I do this first? Or do I do this first?
This needs power.
Okay, so that needs power. So we do this first. Oh, that does not go very far. That doesn't go very far at all. Where am I to take this? Is there something that I like push into the room, maybe? Am I supposed to come out here yet? Is there like something? Okay, those might be things that I push. Are these like power blocks or something? Can I? Nope, I can't push that. Okay. Well, that's not what I do. The top can move? What can move? The top of what? Oh, I see. Okay. Like, I can see that this might be able to, like, slide. Is that what you're saying? It can, like, move across. Yeah. Yeah, okay. I see. I didn't see that myself, so thank you for that. Oh, shoot, it moves back. I should probably be, like, pushing. No, stop. No! No, I keep hitting the wrong button. Get off the fly. I keep pressing the wrong button. Sorry, guys. That's the wrong button. Okay, there we go. Now that's the button. And now the other button. Now the other button. Okay. That was disappointing. Well, is it really a stream of mine if I don't struggle to do a basic task / a puzzle? I'm just like, if it's the last time I get to do this, then we might as well like do it, you know? We gotta do it right. And it's not a Rebels just in stream unless I'm struggling to do basic tasks. Okay. And we got power.
Whoa.
Use
that,
force slow. See, I never do that, do I? There are so many times when force slow would make everything easier and I just forget that I can do it.
I've disabled the shields on the outer sections of the fortress.
Thank you, sir.
Flood the base and swim to the central keep.
Okay.
It's a hell of a plan.
Huh. We'll meet up inside. Good luck.
Got it. Let's go, BD.
All right, let's go. This even where I'm supposed to go.
That section looks pretty weak.
Heck. Get on the pipe! Pipe.
Ready for a swim, BD? Hang on.
Hey, that's what he said when I unlocked the swimming ability, isn't it? It was something like that. It was like, ready for a swim, BD. Was I supposed to go the other way? Was I supposed to go this way? What if I'm going the complete wrong way? I'm just gonna have to go back. No, I can't go through there, so it's gotta- Oh wait! Stop. You guys are gonna be telling me, like, hey, go out the way that you pushed out. Obviously, I don't know if you guys commented that yet. I'm sure you're in the process of it. You guys really, you have to understand, thinking is not working out right now, which really sucks for this game, because this is a game where you have to think. Do I need to go through the pipes over there? No, I'm just gonna keep going this way. This is a game where you should actually, you need to think. And I can't think right now. Thinking is not, So I might be struggling a little bit. Down there, I guess? That's up. We're going down. In an earlier round. And Sugar, we're going down swinging. I'll be your number one. The queen is some emo music up in here. No, that's not the right key, but that's the key that they did it in, and what a catch. So I can sing it in that key if I want to. This way it is! Sugar, we're going down swimming. We're going down, and then around. Sugar, we're going down swimming. Oh boy. Whee! Now I do have 2 skill points. Should I use them? Should I use the skill points? My besties. Yes, okay. So we got 2. We got 2 skill points. I can do the power throw now. But yeah, might as well. Best of both worlds. Didn't even have to worry about, I don't even know if I'm gonna use this, but... You know, maybe I'm gonna be hit with, a whole thing of enemies when I open this door. Yeah, see? Like that.
He's hit! Keep your head down!
Oh, that's cool.
Preparing another attack.
Get out from back there!
BD, we gotta get through this way.
Oh, I should probably make my saber double. That's a good idea. Alright.
No chance!
You and me, Jedi.
You and me!
Something catch your eye? What is it, buddy?
Hey!
Not now!
Go!
her!
You can't stand against us. Oh no. Now he looks mad.
Anyone else? Yeah, you.
Understood.
Are they just gonna keep coming until I, like, do something? Like, is something I have to do here?
I can't hit him. Take him down. Get on him. Get him. Do this.
Oh, I really could have used that, like, push thing. I mean, pull thing. Why are you so hard to kill?
You'll slip eventually.
Okay, what am I actually supposed to do? Like, am I doing all this fighting for no reason? Like, am I supposed to be getting out of here?
I am terminating your life.
No, you're not. I feel like I'm supposed to be doing something, like, over here.
Catch up.
So this is just like basically an arena. Like, I'm not really supposed to be doing anything else. Okay. Are we slicing now?
I think you can handle this, Speedy.
The Jedi. He's in the interrogation room.
Oh my god, even more. This is literally like not another hallway enemy.
Emperor,
give me strength! Oh my god. Yeah, someone else take a hit! Blast you!
Target is highly mobile.
Being very vocal. This is really intense. Where are you? Where are you coming from? Okay.
That's the last of them.
Cal, I'm near your position, but sealed behind a blast door. Look for a console nearby.
Sorry, I'm not, like, commentating very much. This is just, like, so intense. And you already know I'm not feeling it very... I'm not feeling...
Found it.
...cash money tonight anyway. If she dies, this is just like Master T'Pau! Because that's how I was watching him in Order 66. I would look through, like, a viewport, and then he would run.
Impressive. How you holding up?
Don't worry about me. We have a job to do. Still, it feels good to tear this place apart.
Seer, that's not for a Jedi of you.
I only wish there was someone left to save.
I mean, that's more
sorry
Jedi.
Sorry we had to come back here.
Oh!
So am I. But we didn't really
I'm
have
sorry
a choice,
we had to come back here.
I understand.
I'm sorry we
Let's
had to come
moving.
Back here.
Yes. Let's get this over with.
Any sign of Trilla?
No. Not yet. The holocron is being kept in the interrogation chamber. It's the most secure place in this entire fortress. I'm opening the path to the holocron. Get to the holocron. I'll divert reinforcements and join you as soon as I can.
Oh yeah, I'm sure you will. Okay. God, I feel like she's gonna die. I'm so scared. Okay. Let me take a look at the chat. I haven't looked at it in a while. I literally feel sick. I feel literally, like, nauseous right now. About this cope. You're so funny, Mindscape. The last time Cal fought beside another Jedi was during Order 66. You can't say things like that to me when I literally feel nauseous. Anyway. Gives off the same energy as sorry, Omega. I know I promised you'd never have to come back here. Literally, why are you guys saying these things? What about I feel sick to my stomach, you not understand? Like, why are we making things worse? Please. Please, you guys. Be a little bit. Have a little bit of sympathy for this poor soul on the other end of the Twitch stream here. Woo! Okay! Vibing? I'm shaking. I'm also shaking, so if that works. I literally don't even know what I'm supposed to do. Okay. I've, like, completely lost the plot. Was it over here? Oh, it's over here.
It's like a turbo lift.
What?
Might be our ticket out of here.
Alright. An elevator? One last elevator? However I get there? Oh, that's- this looks interesting. That's lots of fire. It's real quiet. It's really quiet. Okay. Oh, here we go. Ticket out. Everyone shut up if you know, just shush. It looks like someone spoke too soon. McClunky. Oh my god. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm gonna put the controller down for a second. I'm gonna hug my knees for a second. I'm gonna try to catch a breath for a second. Silence. Alright, well, you're saying oh boy and you're saying silence and I literally feel sick. This is having such a toll on my physical form. Let me just stop shaking for a second. I'm sorry, I had to put the controller down. I'm really nervous. I see a meditation point in there, which is not promising. That's not promising that there's a safe point in there. That's not promising. I'm gonna just close my eyes for a second. Am I close to finishing the game? Oh my god, I don't feel good right now. I feel like I'm not being as entertaining as you guys want me to be. I'm so sorry. This just
we're getting close.
There's some things.
Thanks for being my friend.
No, I'm sorry. I had to put down the controller again. I know this is going really slow, and it's probably really annoying for you guys. thanks for being my friend. No, he really said, we're getting close. BD1, thanks for being my friend. Why would he say that? Does he think he's making it out of here? Just out of the blue, why would he say, thanks for being my friend? I mean, I know that he kind of says stuff like that all the time. But the line was specifically, we're getting close, thanks for being my friend. Like, he just had to say it, just in case he couldn't say it again. And I also just love how they'll kind of say things like that to each other just out of the blue, and I'm really gonna... And when I finish the game, I'm really gonna miss that so much. Like, that's gonna be one of the specific things that I miss the most, just like... Just Cal and BD1's, like, casual affection for each other. And when I say casual, I just mean, like, they just love each other so much that they can just be like, I love you at any random time. And that's just how they work. Because they love each other so much that they can just be casual about it at any time. That makes sense. And I'm gonna miss that a lot, but also, like, we're getting close. Thanks for being my friend, like... I'm sorry, I'm really prolonging this, and I feel like I'm not, I feel like I'm not being, like, funny and fun, or interesting, or, I'm sorry if this isn't what you wanted it to be. Okay, I don't wanna, I'm sorry, I'm a wreck. I'm a whole disaster right now.
Never seen anything like this. Advanced, even for the Empire.
Is it now? Wasn't there a save point somewhere? Okay, it's up there. What are you doing, Cal? Oh, what did that do? Oh, okay, I needed that.
Broke them, beat them down, and turned them to the dark side.
Ugh, this is so terrible. The save point is making me nervous, to be honest. The save point is making me nervous. Why is there a save point here? Why? Oh my god, what's gonna happen when I slice this open? Oh my god, I just wanna like cry my eyes out right now. I just wanna start like ugly crying. If I didn't stop so much, I'd probably be done the game by now. I'm about to like squeeze the controller so tight that I like break it in half. I don't want to do this. I don't want to open.
It's locked. What do you think?
Oh my god, that's like the interrogation. Not the interrogation chamber. I don't know if you guys know this about me, but I really don't like torture. Every time I watch something with a torture sequence, it literally makes me feel sick. I already feel sick. I don't like that I'm in here. I don't like that I'm in here at all. Can I go there? No, I can't go around that way. Can I just double jump onto there? I'm not really sure if I'll- Oh, so here's an interact. Saw that coming. Hey, girl. Okay, guys, any tips for this fight? Because I don't really know what I'm doing. already winning.
As I have.
So far, I have not gotten a single hit, and she has gotten all of them. I'm not even facing the right way.
That won't change anything. Back here.
Oh, come on, I hit the... Oh, shoot. Stim.
Stim, please.
This is not... I don't think I'm gonna... I might die. I don't think this is gonna work out for me.
Really? Agony. Much longer.
Yeah, apparently not. Come on, let me use my stim, bestie. Shoot. Oh, I'm almost dead. Let me use my stim, please. Stim. Thank you, BD.
Trilla, I saw what you've been through. You've experienced great suffering. It's not too late to let it go.
Let go. I'm stronger now because of the pain. I knew you'd come back for this. No, thank you. You'll never make it out of this place alive!
Heck. What do you need to do? What if she... Is one of them gonna kill the other one?
Nothing is ever truly over.
This fight is over.
What are you...
I know
girl.
The darkness that is eating you up inside, and every day we choose to either feed it or fight it.
Sierra was making me nervous earlier because she was saying she really likes burning this place down.
It's not. I know the choices that I made took all your choices away.
She's been doing so
and
well.
I have failed you, Trilla.
But Sierra's been doing so well. Oh my god, Trilla's gonna like kill her right now.
And I am so very sorry.
Someone's gonna kill someone right now. Someone's about to kill someone. I'm gonna be sick.
I've carried so much hate for you.
Oh. Oh my god! Why? Why? Why?
That doesn't look good.
No, it doesn't.
It's him.
Oh my god.
Field.
Oh my god, he's gonna kill her!
Avenger.
Oh my god!
Run!
Wait, Seer! Seer!
You would be wise to surrender.
No, please, I can't fight right now!
Yes.
I can't probably do a boss battle right now. Come on, I already used all my stims on Trilla! I can't do this!
Feeble.
No! No, I'm not! How do I get out? Pressing all the buttons. Dang. Okay, so how do I do this fight? How do I do this fight? Wait, before I respawn, someone tell me what to do. Do I fight or do I... Okay, force pull on the tubes. Is that what you're saying? Pull on the tubes at the top? Because he didn't have a health bar, so I'm assuming I can't fight him. But I was kind of confused because there were other times... Like, every time I fought Master T'Pol, there was no... Like, it was just story, like, there was no, health bar, so I was sure it was like that. So I pull, and then I run. My first game death at the hand of Darth Vader, so metal. That's actually incorrect. Go watch my last stream to see what my first game death was. It was supremely pathetic and also hilarious. This was my second game death. Okay. So, thanks for reminding me of that. I really needed to laugh. okay. So, pull the things up top and run. Which way do I run? Do I need to turn... Wait, do I need to... Can I turn it down? If I turn it down for myself, just turn it down for you guys. Okay. Which way do I run? Like, do I run left or right or behind me? Run back to the elevator. Okay, so I pull the things up top. Listen, a way can be a lot of ways, and then I'll just fail, okay? So run behind me. Okay, adjust the... Okay, so I guess, do I point up? Which way do I adjust the camera angle? Oh, McClunky says look to the left or the right. Okay. Okay, so look right. Look right and pull and run backwards. Okay, do you think I got this? Alright. Do I have to fight Trilla again? Do I have to do the whole thing again? Okay, well, I fought Trilla once. I can do it again. If I did it once. Okay, well I did- Okay, well I beat Trilla once, so I have to do it again, then I have to do it again. Okay, that sounds just like Vader. Okay, pull, pulling, where am I pulling? What am I pulling? Dang it, I failed again.
Submit.
Oh, wait, I pull at this part, okay. Well, yeah, you gave me control. I could run. Oh my god. You're kidding. Okay.
Turbo left. Let's go.
Great. Not more of these. Well, I like that they're all being taken out. Oh, heck. You know, it's not a Fallen Order stream unless I just fail like that. It's fine. I know what I'm doing now. It's not a Fallen Order stream unless I can't platform. So, we're just completing the experience with this. We're just completing the experience. It's not a Fallen Order stream unless I fail at platforming. But now I know where to pull. We're learning. It's a learning experience. Oh, I get to start here. Okay, that's cool. Whee! Why did that happen? Girl, what just happened? Run faster. We might be here for a while. I'm so bad at sprinting though. Shut up. That's so annoying that I have to do that. Okay. I'm gonna say it right now, we're gonna be here for a while. We're gonna be here for a while. I made it pretty far in that first run where I didn't know what I was doing. Run, my child! Sprint! Do the sprint! I'm so bad at sprinting and I hate it! Oh, shoot! Whee!
Okay.
And interact.
Let's get out of here.
Let's.
What? Come on.
Come on.
Edie, stay back.
Go, elevator, go. Uh-oh. Wee. I gotta do it. One last time. Yeah. Yay. Anyway, we gotta get both of the yes while we're in the spinny elevator. Okay.
I think we lost him. I'll make it. Seer, I won't fail you.
I'm so sorry, baby! Oh my god, did BD1 really ask me if he's okay? And he's like, I'll make it.
Did you read me? They're not responding.
Yeah!
I am certain of it.
Grease, I'm here. Heading towards the surface. Be ready. I have the holocron, but Seer.
Cal, I'm so sorry.
Seer? Just get out of there, Cal. Keep moving, Cal.
And Grease, I'm also so sorry. What am I supposed to do? Are there more? Is there another thing? Is there another? Oh wait, is there another? Stop. You're saying stop, and I don't know what that means. You had to button mash? Okay, I guess I just didn't button mash good enough. I'll button mash better this time. It's true that I did hit the wrong button at first because I was in distress. I hit the square by accident for the first couple seconds, so maybe that's why it didn't work. And then I started hitting the circle, but I guess it wasn't enough. You have to understand. I'm in distress. Talk about running to the door. Wait, so when Vader comes, can I, like, run the other way? Like, what's supposed to happen? This is, like, see, they're just, like, springing this stuff on me and not helping me out at all with what I'm supposed to, like, do. Like, it just spring, like, it's just this, it sprung on me, and it's like I'm expected to know what to do. And I absolutely don't. I absolutely do not. No, so I've got a button pass. Ah!
give it to you.
We shall see.
He's gonna break it. Seer!
I won't let you take those children.
He's gonna kill her now!
Such
so
hatred.
Stressful. I'm literally
you would
shaking.
Have made an excellent inquisitor.
I'm shaking.
She's stronger than that.
Seer?
No.
Seer?
No!
Seer? Seer!
Yes. Strong.
Seer.
The dark side.
Seer.
I can
Seer.
Feel it inside of her.
Seer, no!
Seer! Seer! Hey,
don't be season three, Matt!
You'll have a choice.
Seer! Good! Good! Seer. Make it that far without a rebreather? Good. Good God. Come on, someone save him. Marin! Marin, bestie! Marin, bestie, save me! Please!
Hey.
Thank you. Thank you,
hey.
Marin.
Hey, kid.
Cal. Hey.
Cal. See her. She's all right.
Oh, thank God.
She's all right. You too.
Oh, baby, are you okay? He'll be fine. It's just.
We did it.
We did it.
We did.
Careful. Oh, poor kid.
They're out there.
Whoa, hold on. Wait a minute.
Cal, slow down. You're hurt. Good God. Oh.
Sorry.
Don't hug him too hard, though. He's a. He's not
so. That was you in the water, wasn't it?
I'm glad you're okay.
Thank you, Marin.
This one wouldn't leave your side.
Oh, my dad, my space dad.
Thank you. Hey.
Oh my God, this is about to take me out.
Hey.
This is about to kill me in cold blood.
So now what?
So now what?
Well, Captain, this is the end of my charter.
Yeah.
Your contract has been fulfilled.
But you're fam now. You're family.
Thank you, Grease.
You're family. You can't just leave.
Well, if it's all the same to you.
Yup.
I was thinking that maybe I was
that's
just around
what I
here.
Oh, kill me!
You gotta go. Besides, there's
killing
time
me.
To look up to me.
What about that? We use it to rebuild the Jedi Order. The next generation of Jedi.
The Empire will be after them. Just like they're after us.
The lives of every child on that list will be forever changed.
Not by us.
Hmm?
Their destiny should be trusted to the Force.
That's a good way to think. So the real mission was the therapy we found along the way. Is that how it ends?
I gotta mute myself. I need to really, like, violently, like, ugly cry right now, so please give me a second. I'm really not willing to do this in the microphone. Tried to make that quick, because I don't want to be muted from you guys for too long, because I feel like that's, like, you know, a streamer probably should not just, like, mute themselves in the middle of the stream. So I tried to make that quick for you. Can you hear me? What am I supposed to say? What am I even supposed to say? What a gorgeous game. Just what a gorgeous story. Your friends need you. Yeah, go. Thanks for being here. I hope I wasn't keeping you from your friends for too long. My God. What do I even... What do I say? Literally, what is... This is so much easier when I'm, like, by myself and, like, typing on a story slide. Beautiful story, and what a lovely, just what a wonderful game this was. This was a great first experience with gaming. This is a story that really spoke to me. How lovely was that? Just how... I didn't really know what I was getting into when I picked up this game. I didn't know much about it at all. I knew some character names. I'd seen, like, pictures of Cal in BD1. I knew that I could eventually change colors on my lightsaber. And that's about it. And I don't really know what I expected. I guess I just expected something more, like, action-oriented, maybe? And I was not ready for a story that was so driven by emotion and character. But not just, like, emotion and character, but specifically driven by, like, the theme of healing. In every way that it can be. So, like, showing, like, the whole arc of it, you know? The whole arc of healing. And the damage that needed to be healed from, kind of, because, you know, because Cal is so broken when we find him. And then the struggle that it is in order to heal was, like, so thoroughly explored. And, like, the way that, you know, I don't know, the way that they hurt each other because they're hurt, but also the way that they heal each other because they're hurt. I wasn't ready for a game about all of that. And then the way that when you heal, you can help others to do the same.
the way that they went on journeys individually and also interpersonally. I wasn't ready for that. I wasn't ready for that at all. Like, I knew it was a good game and people said it was a good story, but that's not what I was anticipating. And, like, it's just so, like, there's just so much heart and soul in it. And it's, and I've talked about Star Wars properties this way before, but nothing ever has done it the way this game has done it. And I think that I've been reaching for other Star Wars properties to be what this game was. I think I've been wishing for, and in my mind, imagining that, you know, kind of like watching a show and maybe reaching for it to be what this game actually was. And this is what I've been longing for. Specifically Rebels is one that I think of that comes to mind. And Rebels is a gorgeous show, and I think it is very emotionally open, and I love it for that. I've praised Rebels up and down for having... I tend to use the term emotional awareness. I feel like it's aware in a really... What's the word? What's a good word? Tender. It's aware in a very tender way of how its characters feel. But that's also something that I really want a show to be. And so I think I exaggerate it when I feel it. And I praise Rebels up and down for having that kind of quality of, like, it feels like the show itself cares about how its characters feel. It doesn't just put them through the ringer and kind of not care about how they... Like, I think The Clone Wars does that. Like, The Clone Wars is a very emotional show, but it doesn't feel like it cares about its characters. It's not tender. It's just... It's a very sharp kind of painful. But Rebels is kind of more painful in a tender way, you know what I mean? And I praise it up and down for that, and I... praise it up and down for how the characters feel like they care about each other, and they do, and they absolutely do. But this game did it in the way, like, fully, to the full extent that I've been longing to see. You know? Like, they say the word healing out loud. The characters are constantly asking each other how they are, if they're okay. There's nothing nebulous about how they're traumatized. It's never in uncertain terms. You're never exactly, like, you're not gonna make a headcanon where Cal goes to Ilum and you're like, oh, goodness gracious, it must be hard for him to be there. He says in a line of dialogue that it's hard for him to be there. I've been waiting for this. And he says it's hard for him to be there because BD-1 asks him if he's okay. If that makes sense. And it's so rare. And it's something I long to see so much in a story. And it's never delivered to the degree that I would like to see it, except for this game. How gorgeous of it. How beautiful of it. How, like, heartfelt of it. I don't even know what to say. Alright, let's see what the chat is saying, because I've been rambling for, like, a long time. Oh, but Premium definitely already left, but if you watch this back, Premium, goodbye. What a meaningful narrative of suppressing grief and achieving growth. But no, really. Like, really. Grief, healing, love, and killing. I know you're joking, but, like... grief, healing, and love. That's what it's really about.
It's a heartfelt story about a group of very different people coming together to do the greater good. It focuses on grief and how people deal with it, and how despite being broken, it doesn't mean you're no longer useful. You can work in a different way, like Cal's Kyber Crystal. That's so true. That's so true. Like, the game never shies away from dealing with the fact that its characters are broken. But it also is very kind to them in their brokenness, if that makes sense. And when I say kind to them, I don't mean that it never puts them through anything, because obviously it does. But it's always about... It's not about how broken they are, but it's about, like, who they are and what they can do despite it. And what they can do to move forward, if that makes sense. So there's no... Like, the devastation is very, like, clear and explicit, but... There's also, like, a point of it not defining them, and I think that's so, like... Of it being a huge part of them, but not defining them, if that makes sense. And that's, like... That's a really great story to tell. So y'all think the ninth sister in Malico's could potentially be alive. I guess we'll find out in the second game. I can definitely see the ninth sister being alive. Because that was, what did I do? I cut off her hand and I like force pushed her off the edge of a thing, right? If I remember right, I was kind of in distress at that point because I still thought my bestie was dead. I could totally see her coming back. I mean, hey, Boba Fett can come back. If Fennec Shand can come back. She can do, you know? I wonder the direction they'll go with the second one. Death, that's the direction. I hope not. At least it's not High Republic. Yeah, true. Not to bring Stellan and Bell into this, but... Shut up. I know, it's close, it's coming up. We're less than a month away. Terrible. Absolutely awful. So, Spider-Man PS4, am I right? That's the next journey. That is the next journey. I'll probably start that next week. I'm scared. But yeah, that'll start next week, and I'm sure that I will be, like, neck deep in Spider-Man brain rot, so it'll be a really great time to start it. You know, post No Way Home, I'm sure it's gonna be a fantastic... I'm sure it's gonna be a great time to start the Spider-Man game, because I'm probably gonna be thinking a lot about Spider-Man. Still not over the Ezra and Vader vibes you get from Cal and Vader. Yeah, true. Kingpin time, baby. Yep, that's my next impossible fight. Are you talking about Hawkeye, or are you talking about me playing Spider-Man PS4? Yeah, that fight's not gonna go too well for me. I'm probably gonna die a few times in that. My brother says that the Kingpin fight is, like, low-key the hardest one in the game, even though it's, like, the first one. He's the first boss, if I remember right, right? Because I watched my brother play the beginning of the game. Just, like, the very beginning of the game, where it kind of teaches you how to play it. So I didn't really see any of the I didn't see any of the actual story. It was just, like, the first level. And honestly, that Kingpin fight, like, that very first, like, that was, like, the first boss battle, right? It looks so hard! My brother said that it was, like, the hardest fight in the game. But not because the other ones aren't harder, but because, like, you're really under-equipped for that first one. So you're like, what am I supposed to do? He died a lot of times trying to do that fight, so I imagine that I'm going to die even more. Because we all know I cannot play video games. Is that coming before or after the movie? Is what coming? Me playing the game? Me playing the game is going to come
after the movie. Kingpin and Hawkeye, I guess we technically don't know if it's coming at all. Although, technically he was already in it. But Kingpin and Hawkeye could be before or after the movie. Because there's two episodes left in Hawkeye. And one is this Wednesday, so I guess that's kind of before the movie, since it officially comes out on Friday. And then one the week after. So, I guess if he's appearing, it's gonna be in one of those, I guess. So, it could be before or after the movie. Yes, the game. The game is coming after the movie. Because I'm gonna get offline pretty much from Wednesday to Saturday night. Because I'm seeing the movie on Saturday night, and I do not want it to be spoilered. Can't. I don't want it to be spoiled, so I'm just gonna kind of go offline. And if I stream, then there could be someone who thinks it's funny to, like, come in the chat and, like, comment spoilers. And I don't want that. I don't want anyone commenting spoilers on my stream. So I will not be hosting any streams this for the rest of this week. And then after I see the movie, I will go and do Spider-Man PS4. But I hope that no one spoils it in the chat for people who might be in the chat who haven't seen it, because that would suck. I know that no one looks at the, like, channel rules, but on my about section, I do have a couple channel rules, and one of them is not to spoil anything ever. So if anyone looks at the rules and decides to follow them, then they'll know. But, what if they do Kingpin in the show right before the movie just to set up Matt? That's kind of what I would be, like, thinking they would do if Matt is even in No Way Home, which, to be quite honest with you, I'm not really holding my breath. Like, is it a possibility? Yes, it's a possibility that I'm fully aware of. It's not gonna take me off guard if he's in the movie, just because of how much we've been talking about it. But to be quite honest, I don't really think that Matt's gonna be in No Way Home. And I could be completely wrong about that. Maybe he's in it. Maybe he is. I just feel like that's a really big deal, and it's the kind of thing where it just feels like we want it so bad that it feels like a pipe dream, and it can't actually happen, and it won't actually happen. It just feels outlandish. You know, does that make sense? Like, it just feels like it's too much what we want for it to actually happen. So if he's not in it, I won't be surprised. If he is in it, I won't really be surprised, but I'm not really holding my breath for it. However, if he is in it, and in the event that he is in it, putting Kingpin in this upcoming episode of Hawkeye would be a great way to introduce him. Mephisto all over again. See, that's the thing. Like, I was not positive that Mephisto was going to be in WandaVision. Everyone else was. And I was like, we don't know that for sure. People have, like, their theories about who they think should be in something, and then they start treating it like fact. And it's not. Did you write the show? Did you write the movie? No! We don't know what happens. We don't know who's in it. We don't know until we sit down and watch the movie. There's no use in treating fan theories and fan wishes and rumors like facts. There's no use in it. So until something is confirmed, I pretty much assume that, maybe it won't happen, you know? And I haven't seen any... I mean, the movie isn't out yet, so there's no confirmation of whether or not Matt's in No Way Home. As far as I know, unless they're... I don't know. I don't really look at... I try not to look at, like, leaks and stuff. Because I don't want it to be spoiled. I'm pretty good at avoiding spoilers. So, if it's a spoiler that I've managed to avoid, then I've managed to avoid it. But to me, until I, like, sit down and see a movie, there's nothing that's sure to me. So I'm not, like... I'm like, yeah, maybe Matt's not in No Way Home. Anyway. Alright, what are we doing? What are we doing in the chat here? Presuming I won't be active in DMs then. I might be a little bit active. Not as active as sorry, not as active as usual. But I don't want to, like, the people who, I probably won't be answering, like, random DMs, or, like, people who I don't talk to a lot, but the people who I talk to a lot, I don't really want to, like, leave you high and dry, and I assume that you wouldn't spoil it for me. People who I think I can trust, I'll probably answer DMs. But not very active. No. Afraid but excited for Spider-Man PS4. You probably should be. I am. I'm excited for a good game, but I'm afraid about what it's going to do to me. This is the longest you've stayed on a stream. Proud of you. I'm proud of you too. Thanks for sticking around, Mindscape. But yeah, so exciting things coming up. McClunky and I are also working on our joint Disney Infinity era, by the way, if anyone wanted to know. We're not really sure what's gonna come of it, but we're working on it. Will you make your stories in highlights? Because I'm gonna see it after you, but still want to read your stories. Assuming that I go on a No Way Home rant, which I probably will, since I used to do a lot of that on, I used to be very mildly Tumblr famous on MCU Tumblr, and the last time a Spider-Man movie came out, I was still relevant, so I could, I just went and posted all my thoughts on there, but you know what? I don't really use that Tumblr very much anymore, because no one pays attention to me anymore. So my outlet is Instagram now. So I actually guess if I have any rants, I guess they'll be going on Instagram. So in that case, I didn't really consider that. Yeah, so I will put them in a highlight, since the rant will likely be going on Instagram. Assuming I have a rant, which I'm sure I do. Yeah. So some exciting things coming up. We got Hawkeye on Wednesday. We got No Way Home this weekend. And then I start Spider-Man PS4. I don't really know what I'm gonna do between now and then. But I think it's something else. Oh, West Side Story! I'm thinking of maybe seeing it tomorrow night. Maybe. I could have seen it today, but I didn't. Because I didn't want to get off the couch, so I didn't. But I really want to see it. Although, like, am I ready for the emotional annihilation of this version of West Side Story? I don't know. But maybe, possibly, tomorrow night. Because tomorrow during the day I'm gonna be busy. And then I have, like, my last final... I have a final period, which is gonna be, like, presentations tomorrow, like, afternoon. But then I won't even have any, like, homework or anything to do tomorrow night. So tomorrow night I can probably go see West Side Stories. Hopefully I can do that. Maybe I might not feel like leaving my house. I don't know. But, let's hope I do feel like leaving my house. You know what? I wanted to see Eternals again. I've been wanting to see Eternals again since literally when I saw it the first time. And I never did. Like, there's so many movies I want to see, but now all the new, like, there's so many new things coming that I can't... I wanted to see Eternals again this entire time, but now I want to see West Side Story, and then No Way Home's coming out. I'm at college right now, but, then I'm going, like, back home, so then it's not- I can't just, like, go to the movie spontaneously when I'm at home, because, like, I don't know, I feel like I just can't. Because here, like, my parents aren't here, like, I can do whatever I want, you know? It's not- it doesn't have to be an event. It doesn't have to be, ooh, I'm doing a thing. I can just go to the movies if I want. But I feel like if my parents are there, I'm like, hey, I'm like- it's just awkward. So, anyway, that was a tangent. Pretty sure Eternals comes to Disney Plus in early January. But is that premiere access, or is it free? Because I don't want to pay for it, is the thing. Because paying, like, if you're a family and you paid $30 for premiere access, that's one thing. Because if you're a family, you'd be paying for, like, three or four movie tickets. But for me, I'd spend, like, $25 to see it in the movies, and it's, like, $30 to see it on Disney Plus. So I don't want to pay for it. But then I have to wait even longer. It would be free. Oh, they don't do that anymore? They don't do Premier Access anymore? I mean, I know that Shang-Chi didn't have Premier Access because of Disney Plus Day, but are they just not doing it, like, in general anymore? Well, that'd be nice. I'd appreciate it. Anyway. Dude, what do I do without Fallen Order? I'm sad. I already miss Cal. He's my best friend. Cal Kestis is my best friend. What am I gonna do? I could play it again. I could play it again. But that's not the same as playing it for the first time. I wish I could. Before I was even finished the game, I wasn't even done the game yet. There was probably some stream where I said this. But, like, I wish I could play it for the first time again. And I wished that before I was even finished playing it. I wasn't even done, and I was like, I wish I could play it for the first time again. Not that I didn't... It's not the kind of thing where I feel like I didn't appreciate it enough the first time. Because I definitely feel like I appreciated it the first time. Would you say I appreciated it? I think I did. But it's just, like, that experience was so, like, everything to me that I wish I could do it again. But you never can get back that first time. And this is the... I've literally been reacting to Fallen Order the same way that I reacted to Daredevil. Right down to feeling sick to my stomach. Anyway. And I know that one of the things that I was thinking about watching Daredevil was, like, I wish I could, like, I'm never gonna get to watch this for the first time again. And it's just, like, true. Redoing, rewatching, like, it's not the same. I wish I could meet Cal Kestis again. And I can't do that. But that's also fine. You changed my life, you funky little ginger. I love you. That's fine, because now I don't have to meet him again, because I know him. And maybe that's better. Just notice that the screen is the escape pod, Cal escapes as the Venator explodes. Bruh. Dude, I've been looking at this loading screen, like, every time. And I wasn't even thinking about it. Anyway. I can go explore the planets and... I could 100% it. Yeah, I could just go and explore. Do my little exploration shenanigans. Because you know I love some exploration shenanigans. You know what's fantastic? Nobody in the core crew died. Everybody on the Mantis is alive. That's awesome. Nobody died. Yeah. That's nice. I can't believe you finished this and Daredevil in the same night. Well, I meant no one on the Mantis died. Did I not say that? Did I only say that in my head? Obviously Trilla died, which is very sad, but I wasn't talking about that. I was talking about I said the core group. Did I only say that in my head? Did I not say that out loud? Well, anyway, if I didn't say it out loud, I was talking about, like, the core characters. Like, the crew of the Mantis. Nobody died. Like, Seer didn't die. I really thought she was gonna die. And then I really thought she did. But I'm glad she didn't. Just have to commend Cameron Monaghan's performance as Cal. I already knew he was a talented actor, really brought that talent to Star Wars. I feel like I've mentioned that, like, throughout the streams, that, like, the performances were really, like, cutting right to my soul. But no, for real. The performances in this game, and definitely the highlight being Cameron, they were so, like, nuanced and, like, kind of, like, vulnerable, I guess. There's something so, like, intimate and very, like, real about it. And Cameron really did an incredible job with even, like, getting, you know, and the developers too as well, you know, with getting, like, facial expression through, with, you know, I guess a more limited sort of animation. Because, like, you know, they can't have all the nuance of, like, an animated movie, say, or, like, of CGI. But the ability to, like, get expression through, his voice work was incredible. Just so, like, he just had such a wonderful delivery of so many of the lines, where there were so many lines where I just thought, like, you could have just said that, and instead you thought about how to say it. Does that make sense? Like, kind of in particular with lines, like, the two that I'm thinking of. Was the one on Ilum, when I know I keep bringing up this line, the one on Ilum when he said, no, I'm not alright, it's hard to be here. And the one on the Venator, where I think BD1, like, asked him if he was okay, and he was like, yeah, I'm okay, and then he might have said, like, it brings back memories or something. But, like, those two moments, I was like, you literally could have just, like, you could have just said that. And I feel like there are some video games where you might have. Even some, like, animated shows. You would've just kind of said it. Where there would've been some feeling behind it. But that felt like... I don't know. Like, he really thought about how to say it. Like, lines... Like, I guess what I'm trying to say is that nothing felt like a throwaway line, even when it was kind of written to be. And I talk about the dialogue in this game all the time, and how, like, the random optional dialogue just, like, makes me go crazy. And that's kind of why. Because even when dialogue was optional, or even when dialogue was not in a cutscene, it didn't feel like it. It didn't feel random, because the delivery was so good and so deliberate. And that was a lot of dialogue to record. There was a lot of it. And yeah, that was something that I've been thinking about throughout the game, Cameron's performance. He, like, really brought it. He really brought it. Fantastic job, for real. I have not seen Gotham myself. I am aware of Cameron's role in it. And I hear that he does a very good job. I did see a trailer, I think. He seemed very good in the trailer. I've considered giving Gotham a try a few times over the years, but I'm just not sure if I'd like it, to be honest. Is it good? I don't know. It seems like the kind of network drama that I would just get very tired of. But is it, like, good, though? I don't know. Does it fall off? I don't know. I'm certainly aware of Cameron and his role in Gotham. And he seemed like he did a really good job. And I've heard people say as much. Gotham is meh, it's good sometimes, maybe. Yeah, that's what I thought. That's kind of what I assumed. And I figured I probably wouldn't even want to finish it if I started it. Like, I don't know. I only have so much patience with shows like that, to be honest with you. Oh, McClunky says the first season is really dumb but really fun and the rest is great. Okay, so now I'm getting mixed signals. I don't know. Maybe I'll give it a try sometime. Depending on how it's dumb, I'd either be down for it or I would find it trifling. What if Arcane? I literally don't have it in me. Stop. Everyone stop bullying me to watch Arcane. I know about it. There's nothing more you can do. Okay? Succession, anyone? Succession, people sure do seem to like it. I don't think it's for me. That's not to say it's bad, I just don't think it's for me personally. Seems a little bit edgy for me personally. But people sure do like it, and people sure are saying that it's like the best show on TV right now. So I hope you're having fun with it. It's like that this is so ridiculous that it's fun kind of dumb for Gotham. I mean, like with the like campy drama network shows, just like they kind of lose me. Like I can't do any more of those. Unless, like, okay, you know what's been keeping my attention? Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. That one has kept me hooked. Although I've been on a major hiatus of watching it because of Daredevil. Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. is keeping me hooked, though. Usually that kind of show I get tired of, but Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. just kind of slaps. I'm on season 5, so I don't know if it's, like, bad after that. But although I hear people say that season 5 is bad, and I have not thought that season 5 is bad. Maybe I just haven't watched enough of it yet, I don't know. Did I miss? Oh, I missed things about Cal. I'm so sorry. That's what I'm literally here to talk about. And I missed things in the chat about Cal. Mocap tech appreciation. Absolutely. Mocap did wonders for this game. Gorgeous. Cameron carried every scene he was in Gotham. I'm not surprised. And, like, in Fallen Order, the ambient lines. Yeah, yo, exactly. Like, that's the thing. Like, the lines where he didn't have to go that hard. But he did on every single one. Like, they were not approached. They were not delivered, like, ambient lines. Ever. He never just said stuff because they knew it had to, like, fill a gap in the video game. Like, it was clear. This man was like, I have a script. Like he was doing a movie or something. You know? No lines were ambient lines. And I think that's kind of what I've been trying to get at in various ways that I've been talking about, specifically the Venator wreck. Even the ambient things in this game don't, like, feel ambient. And I think that almost feels like it was done on purpose. Like, the thoroughness and the dedication to narrative and to, like, character arcs was amazing. Because even when I would deviate from the narrative, they would weave in, like, dialogue and stuff that would make it feel like I did not deviate from the narrative. Like, when I went off on my, like, exploration shenanigan adventures, there would still be, like, dialogue about what was going on. Like, on the planet that I was on and stuff. And I was like, I'm not even supposed to be here! You really programmed in dialogue to make it feel like I was supposed to be here? Like, there shouldn't be any dialogue here at all! I'm not supposed to be on this planet right now, and yet I was supposed to be on that planet. You know what I'm saying? And, like, with the Venator wreck specifically, that felt, like, so integral to Cal's character, to his character arc. I was like, I really could have done the game without even doing the Venator wreck. But it feels like that can't be. Because in my head, the Venator wreck was, like, an important point in Cal's character arc, but the whole thing was ambient. Like, the whole thing was not even, it wasn't an actual plot point. But to me, it was. Because that's how, like, this game was crafted. For nothing to just be throwaway. And it was really immersive for that. Bye, Mindscape! The DuckTales finale. Oh my god, I forgot about that. When you and then Mindscape finished the show before I do, and I literally watched it while it was airing. You know, I'll watch it eventually. There's always the Fallen Order comic. Yes! Yes, absolutely. Who printed the Fallen Order comic, and can I read it when I renew my Marvel Unlimited subscription? Is it a Marvel publication? Hold on. Googling it. It is. It's a Marvel comic. Okay. So, is it on Marvel Unlimited? Fallen Order Dark Temple? It is on Marvel Unlimited. Fantastic. So I was going to renew my Marvel Unlimited subscription to read Daredevil comics. Because that's exactly what I need to do. So maybe I can read that while I'm at it. The commitment shows. The commitment absolutely shows. It was so clear that, like, everyone involved in doing this was so committed to it. It looked gorgeous. It was so expressive, both visually and vocally, and it just felt like there was a lot of care. It just felt like everyone cared about it so much. Yeah, that was really something special. That was really something special. For real. Alright. Should I finish Daredevil tonight? Would that be a good idea? This is really nice, getting to talk after finishing the game. I feel like I'm able to not just get completely lost in it. That's what happened with Daredevil. I mean, closure, bad idea, but yes, do it. I mean, like, the ending of Daredevil, though. I mean, I have to get there, but the ending, though. I'm considering it. I could finish the Daredevil rewatch tonight. I could. Not me finishing Fallen Order and Daredevil in the same night. Like, what is wrong with me? And not me watching 3x12, like, right before playing this. That was a... I would like to know how I would have held up if I didn't do that. Because I was genuinely struggling back there. Like, I actually, like... I don't know if anyone thought I was kidding, but I actually, like, kind of thought I was going to be sick. To be quite honest with you. I was getting nervous about it. I feel fine now. Because I'm not nervous anymore. But I was... I was getting concerned. And maybe that wouldn't have happened if I didn't watch 3x12 before doing the stream. But on the other hand, the experience was kind of heightened, I guess. Is that a good thing? Yeah, like, I can just watch it to get to the last few minutes. Now, unfortunately, I'll have to deal with everything, like, before that. What if I skip the entire episode and just watch the ending? I could do that. Well, you know what? If I didn't skip 3x12, then it's not even worth skipping anything out. Like, if I'm gonna, like, if I don't skip 3x10 and if I don't skip 3x12, then, like, don't... I might as well not skip anything. Like, not just the first few minutes, but the first, like, maybe, like, 40 minutes. It's fine. You know, I could do that tonight. I could finish the Daredevil rewatch. Why did I watch season 3 so fast? That was such a mistake. When you realize the Endgame Tony Stark hologram is a Daredevil reference. Wait. Why? Oh, wait, I literally said that the first time I watched the series and I completely forgot what you're talking about. That's so funny. No, because I literally, the first time I watched the series, I literally said the same thing. Probably to McClunky. And I really just read that and I was like, what are you talking about? Oh, I'm so stupid. Anyway. I've lost my privileges of skipping at this point. Celebrate the struggle till the end. Yeah. Like, I should just skip things because it's good for me. It's just good for my health. And I don't. I think the first time... I'm pretty sure the first time I, like, either closed my eyes or turned away from the screen at the end of 3x12. And I don't even think I blinked this time, so that, like, that... I think that was a mistake on my part. That really put me into a state of mind going into finishing Fallen Order. Was that... It was a mistake. I can admit that it was a mistake. But I knew it was gonna be a mistake, so... You know. I knew what I was doing. For the record, I'm pretty sure you did tell me about Tony and Daredevil. I'm pretty sure it was in your DM, but also... My DMs were... In my entire Instagram career, my DMs were not more active than they were the first time I was watching Daredevil. I was having, like, 10 different conversations at all times. So, like, I'm pretty sure I said that to you. I also probably said it to someone else, to be honest with you. I don't know, maybe I'll do that. Maybe I'll go and finish Daredevil, what do we think? What do we think?
Should I go and sign off and finish Daredevil? Okay, so the two of you. The two of you. I talked about it with... Well, no, I remember... See, well, with you, I wasn't specifically talking about it being, like, Endgame. But I do remember we were talking about how Daredevil uses the convention... Like, Daredevil's very, like, theatery. And we were generally talking about that. And I remember... Like, I actually remember this. I was thinking about it while watching... Like, while I was just watching it tonight. I think about this all the time, by the way. This conversation I have with you. And I was like, the only thing we're missing is a soliloquy. I wish that there was a way to do a soliloquy in a cinematic context, but there's really not. And you were like, maybe the closest thing that we get is that. And I was like, shut up. I think about that all the time. What, are you about to say do it? But not in a Palpatine way, in a Dewey way? That's so funny, we have two do-its now. If you're a DuckTales fan and a Star Wars fan and you say do-it out loud, like, how is someone to know what you're referencing? Are you referencing Star Wars or are you referencing DuckTales? Anyway. Say it. Do-it is a poor man's doing it. Yeah, I guess it is. Doing it. You know, maybe I will. Maybe I will. It's early enough. It's only 11 o'clock my time. Sometimes I'm on here until like midnight. Finish Daredevil. It's like 2-for-1 closures in one day. That's actually true. Like, it's kind of a vibe. Because I never reacted to anything the way I reacted to Daredevil until I watched Daredevil, and I was like, wow, I'm never gonna react to anything like that again. And then I reacted to Fallen Order literally the exact same way. Like, the parallels in my experience with Fallen Order and my experience with Daredevil is pretty real. it was, in a lot of ways, just this experience was so similar. So, you know, if I have closure for one of them today, maybe I should just do closure for the other. We'll wrap it all up. We'll wrap it all up. Can you stream Daredevil? Wouldn't that be like a copyright infringement? Like, would I get a copyright strike for that? I don't even know if I'd... It's probably not possible anyway, but even if it were possible, I'd probably get a copyright strike for that. I'm an affiliate, you guys. I can't be getting copyright strikes. I have to be careful. I gotta follow rules, you know? Fallen Order is copyrighted too. But maybe because Fallen Order is a game, then I can stream it. Like, I don't know if there's a difference. I don't really know what the copyright, like, laws are. But people don't... But, you know, people make money off of, like, streaming games, so I guess it's fine. I don't know. But yeah, I feel like I definitely get a copyright strike for even attempting to stream me watching Daredevil. And I can't do that. I'm a Twitch affiliate. I can't be breaking the rules. I don't know how many strikes I get, like 3. But no, I gotta follow the rules now. I gotta wait 24 hours to post my stream to YouTube. I gotta not have copyright strikes, you know. Serious. Meaning we need a Daredevil video game. Isn't there talks of one? I feel like I've heard whispers. Unless it's just fan theories, I don't know. I'm only just getting into gaming, so I don't really know gaming rumors and stuff. But a Daredevil video game would be very cool, and I'm sure it would be amazing.
if it's anything like this, and if it's anything like the Spider-Man games, which, of course, I haven't played them, but their reputation precedes them. That would be a very painful game, though. I'd be crying into the mic like nobody's business. Are you excited to stream Eclipse? I don't know if I'll be able to play Eclipse. Because all I really have access to is a PS4. And I'm not sure if they're going to have a PS4 release for that, or if it's just going to be for PS5. So I'm not sure if I will be able to play Eclipse. But I guess I'll find out. And the same goes for Fallen Order 2, which sucks. And that's something I realized kind of in the middle of playing it. I'm like, oh, heck. I can't do a PS5. We're not getting Eclipse for at least 3 to 4 years. Well, I guess I'll have to be waiting even longer then. Because, I mean, the whole reason why... Because people have been asking me for years, when are you going to play Fallen Order? Have you played Fallen Order? Are you going to play Fallen Order? And every time I have to explain, well, I can't play it yet. Because, well, we have a PS4, but my brother uses it. And it's not really convenient for me to use it, and I don't really get the chance to use it, so I don't really have access to any way to play Fallen Order. But my brother's gonna get a PS5, and then I'll be able to use a PS4, and then I'll be able to play Fallen Order. So, same deal. It's the same deal with any new games coming out. The whole reason why it took me this long to play Fallen Order, and also the whole reason why I have been able to play it now, is because I finally got the hand-me-down PS4. But now I've run into the same problem with any new games coming out. So you'll just, I don't know, you'll have to wait on it, I guess. Because my brother literally just got the PS5, so it's gonna be lasting him for a while. That's okay, there's always Battlefront. I was actually planning on doing the Battlefront 2 campaign. I think I probably said this before, you're getting tired of me saying it. But I was planning on doing the Battlefront 2 campaign because I read the book about the Imperial characters, and now I want to know what happens to them. I mean, I have a vague idea of how it ends. Because I read a book that involved their daughter, I want to say. I read Resistance Reborn, so they, like, mentioned some things. So I have some idea of what happens, but I don't know how we get there, and I don't know anything about the Rebellion storyline. So I actually was thinking about playing the Battlefront 2 campaign. Yeah, like, Shriv. Like, I don't know, like, I don't even know who Shriv is. I mean, like, obviously I know who Shriv is, and I read Resistance Reborn. He was one of the main characters in Resistance Reborn, so I know him from that. But I haven't, like, watched the campaign or obviously played it, so... Shriv! I need to meet Shriv! You know? Shriv, my dad. I'm sure he'll be mine, too. He seems like a cool guy. I would very much like to meet him. But I'm not quite there yet. I still have 2 Spider-Man games to play. And that will keep me very much occupied. Very much occupied. 2 whole Spider-Man games to play. I haven't heard much about Miles other than that it's, like, really good. But how am I going to fare emotionally for that one? Because I already know that Spider-Man is going to be the death of me. But is Miles also going to be the death of me? My brother said that he thought Miles was more emotional than Spider-Man.
Which kind of, I wasn't expecting him to say that. But my brother also, like, does not emotionally react to things very much. So, like, I don't know if I can, like, trust his take. Like, him thinking that one thing is more emotional than another thing is not... I don't know if I can trust that opinion, but what do you guys think? Haven't played Spider-Man, you only have an Xbox. RIP. Fly. Die. Die. Yes, I just killed a fly, a giant fly, with my bare hands. He's been bothering me for forever. Hitting my ceiling and buzzing around my room, he's been very annoying. But I just smacked him on my desk and he's dead now. Alright. There's always Lego Marvel Superheroes. Lego Marvel Superheroes is elite. Lego Marvel Superheroes 2, specifically the character creator, awesome. The character creator on Lego Marvel 2 was so good. We had way too much fun making characters. I legit made like OCs on that game, which is kind of cringe. I still think about them. I had like serious stories that I planned for them and that I like came up with for them and like everything. I loved that character creator so much. That was awesome. You haven't played Lego Marvel 2? Oh, you should. It's so much fun. The lobby, I guess? Like, the open world? Once you, like, unlock all the sections of the open world, it is so much fun to just run around in and just mess around in. I mean, the New York one from Lego Marvel, like, 1 was iconic. Nothing can beat the New York map. That was so much fun. But the Lego Marvel 2 map is literally so much fun to mess around in. It's like very intricate and has like a lot of different it has a big variety of like places. It's really fun. When you thought the saddest death of the stream was cough cough, but it's actually the flies. No, the flies' death is not sad. He was annoying and I killed him. He was very annoying. Like, last night, I was just trying to watch Daredevil last night, and the squirrels were, like, going at it in my walls, and this fly was buzzing loudly on my ceiling because it's a giant fly, and I was like, please. I'm just trying to enjoy. Well, maybe not. I'm just trying to cry to some Daredevil. And the wildlife was like, no. But I just ignored them. Heck yeah, fly lore. I actually haven't played Lego Avengers. I've only played Lego Marvel Superheroes. But we love Lego games, though. Lego games was pretty much all of my gaming experience before now. My gaming experience before now was some Lego games, copious amounts of Disney Infinity, and I don't know if you guys know what Disney Universe is, but that's a game that I had when I was a kid. I think that's what it was called, Disney I'm looking it up now to see if that's the right game. Yes, Disney Universe. And that was pretty much all of my gaming expertise before now. It was a bit of a jump, bit of a learning curve to go and play like a real game. What do you mean? Lego games are the pinnacle of gaming. That's a real game. Did I play anything else? I mean, I played, like, Wii games. I was bad at Mario Kart, and we had, like, Wii Sports or something. Like, I don't know, I guess, like, I played those games, but I don't think that really counts.
I don't think that counts. I mean, like, because it's not, like, the same kind of controller. Like, I don't know. Because the other games we had were an Xbox, so that was kind of more, like, gaming-y. I don't know. Were those really the only games that I played? I guess I just played so much Infinity that it felt like more than one game. Because I played so much of it. I miss Infinity. I'm so excited to be able to play it again. The flies have infested your dining room for days on end. RIP. Rest in peace. We hate dining room flies. Alright, well, I think I'm gonna wrap up the stream right about here. Wow, you guys. Thank you. You know, I just want to say, here on the... To wrap up the very last Fallen Order stream, it's been a beautiful game that I am going to treasure for the rest of my life. This is easily one of my new favorite Star Wars stories. It's become so meaningful to me. It touched me in a way that I haven't been touched before or since Rebels, which it takes like kind of a lot to do that. And I especially want to say thank you to you guys. Because I didn't know if this was going to work. I didn't know if anyone was going to want to watch me. I didn't know if I would just basically be playing on a stream with myself. And there'd be zero people watching. And I'd still stream anyway so I could post it. But no one would be watching. And there was always someone watching. There was always multiple people watching, which is amazing. And there's people, you know, who ask me, like, when's it going to be up on YouTube? And it's been... I'm really happy that you received it. Thank you so much for being so encouraging and helpful, because I know I'm not good at this. I know that I'm not a gamer. I know that it takes me 7 minutes to try and do platforming. I know that I never know where I'm going. And that could have been really annoying, but instead, you guys were very encouraged. I know that I suck at fighting also, by the way, which combat is, like, the draw of watching a gamer, and I just suck at it. And you guys stuck around anyway, so thank you. But really, thank you for being so encouraging and helpful, because you could have just stopped watching. You could have just said, this is annoying and terrible gameplay, and you could have just made fun of me and left. And instead, you were my walkthrough. You were always there telling me which direction to go and what I was doing wrong and how to help me out. And that was just so helpful. And you're always telling me, like, you're doing better than I did on my first time. And, like, you're doing a good job. And that was just really nice of you. It could have gone in the complete other direction. And it didn't, because you guys were awesome. So thank you so much. I love you guys. I'm always just so impressed by how my little corner of the community is just so lovely. So thank you so much for being lovely. And you know, really solid start to the gamer era. I'm really happy about it. It's a success because of you guys. And I know that everyone says that every time they do anything. And I know this isn't like a big deal or anything. You know, I've got maybe like 7 to 10 like core people who typically watch, so I know it's not a big deal, but I consider that a success. If I always have people watching, and if I have people responding to it, even if it's just a handful, that's a success to me. And so it couldn't have been successful if there weren't people who were willing to go along in the ride with me and watch me stream every day for like 4 hours. I love the commitment. I can't believe you guys were so committed. Thank you so much for that. I don't really know what I did to, deserve a little crew online, but it's really cool of you to be here. So, basically, I just wanted to say thank you so much. I think this was a great kickoff to the gamer era.
really happy with the, you know, continued reception. I think this is a great game to start out with. It was a really good story for me. It really spoke to me. And I had such a good time with it. The days when I didn't get to play, I felt it. I wished I could. It's been really fun. And also, thank you for putting up with my, like, emotional disasterness. Because again, this story hit on, like, the highest level of ways that stories can hit me. The two things that I compared it to were Rebels and Daredevil, and literally no other story has hit me as hard as Rebels and Daredevil. So, like, this went all the way to, like, the top of hitting me hard. So, you know, thank you for being there for me. But also genuinely thank you for being there for me, because if I were playing this alone, I think I would have, like, genuinely struggled with some parts. I mean, oh my god, this was bad. Tonight was bad enough as it was. It would have been worse without other people there. And it's also, like, I think I can express my feelings better when I know that I have people listening. Because otherwise it would just be, like, me alone with my monitor. And I'd be like, what do I, you know, like, what do I do right now? It's nice to know that there's someone listening. So, thank you guys so much. I hope you enjoyed the stream tonight. I hope you enjoy my future games. And I think I'm gonna be signing off. So, thank you so much again. And, have a good night, you guys. I'm really glad you could be here tonight. Thank you.